Marshall. This is Blaze the Movie Fan, and it's the end of the month again. You know what that means? Time for another requested review. And today I will be reviewing Cinderella 3 at First in Time, which was requested by Margot Chan. Now, I'm not sure if he or she watches my channel anymore, since the request was made a long time ago. But by my surprise, the channel is still around, so I will be linking it in the video description below. Anyway, fucking thank you. I'm glad that you requested me to review this movie, because I fucking hated this movie for years. And now, it's finally time to talk about it. Now, I'm not at all a hater of the animated direct-to-DVD sequels. In fact, I think that they get far more hate than they deserve. You know, similarly on how I feel about the live-action remix nowadays, my favorite is Return of Jafar, and I stand by that. I could easily make a whole video defending that movie. And I have a link to it in the video description below. And there are plenty others I love, such as The Little Mermaid 2, Return to the Sea. In fact, I love most of them. But there are some which I hate, such as The Hunchback of Notre Dame 2 and The Lion King 2, Simba's Pride. Yeah, isn't it ironic that one of the few animated direct-to-DVD sequels which I hate is the one that most people consider to be the least awful? And of course, the movie I will be reviewing today, Cinderella 3, Twist in Time. My god, I fucking hate this movie. So basically, Lady Tremaine finds a magic wand and goes back in time to change the events of the first Cinderella movie. We're gonna start by talking about Lady Tremaine, played by Susan Leggersley. Since I can't remember the last name, I'm just gonna call her the evil stepmother. And I'm not referring to her as a lady because she is no fucking lady. Anyway, the main issue that I have with her in this movie is that she's basically a villain version of a Mary Sue. Meaning, for a villain, she is too fucking perfect. I mean, seriously, she accomplishes her evil goals flawlessly, I might add, and has no struggles with it at all. And she's always at the top of things in this movie. Oh, and the wand that she steals from the fairy godmother? Yeah, there's absolutely no legit reason why she should have been able to use it and do exactly what she wants with it so flawlessly. It's common knowledge in fiction that magic is not easy to use at all. This is well established in the Harry Potter movies that show the Fairly Odd Parents, that show Charmed, and more. In the old shows and movies, you need to fucking practice before you can use magic flawlessly. So the fact that she's able to do so without a problem is so fucking dumb. Now then, the next character that I want to talk about is the fairy godmother played by Rosie Taylor. I have a question to ask. Why the hell is she even hanging around with Cinderella in this movie? In the first Cinderella movie, it's clear that she met off with Cinderella because she fucking needed her. And since she had a happy ending, it would make sense that the fairy godmother wouldn't even be talking to her anymore, since she wouldn't be needing her. Well, she never exactly says that, but logic dictates that should be the case. But no, during the events of this movie, she still meets up with her like she's a good friend or something. Makes no damn sense. Oh, and by the way, she's a dumbass in this movie. Why do I say this? Because it's completely her fault that her stuff got stolen. Any good magician would take good care of their magic wand or other magical objects. But she dropped it on the fucking ground. And because of that, of course I don't feel bad when something bad happened to her. It is her fault for not being careful enough. Now I'm going to talk about Gus and Jack, played by Corey Burton and Rob Paulsen. Now the mice were the biggest part of the original animated movie, so I'm glad they got less screen time in the live action remake. I didn't exactly find them funny in that movie, but to give credit, at least in that movie, they were only in the background. They didn't do too much, therefore they weren't too annoying. But in this movie, they are a major fucking focus. Oh, and in the original movie, the only person they interacted with was Cinderella. But in this movie, they interact with a lot of fucking people. Fucking ridiculous! I mean, seriously, you remove any charm that they had in the original animated movie, and even though I don't like them in that, I am willing to admit that they have some charm by doing that. Oh, and another big issue that I have with this movie is the failed slapstick. This movie has a lot of slapstick, and none of it is funny at all. In fact, it's fucking embarrassing. It also doesn't help that a lot of it is completely unnecessary. Yeah, that is the main reason why the slapstick in this movie is very fucking unfunny. Since it really doesn't add anything. But now it's time to go to spoiler territory because I have to talk about how fucking awful the ending is. So let's go. Now remember how I brought up how the stepmother is too fucking perfect? Honestly, I could say the exact same fucking thing about the mice. The stepmother should have won in the end. There's absolutely no legit reason why she lost. There's absolutely no reason why Cinderella should ever have figured out that her stepmother was using a spell. And there is no reason at all why the prince should have figured that out either. The only reason why any of these characters figured out the truth is because the mice were too fucking perfect. I mean seriously, they managed to get to Cinderella flawlessly. They managed to get the key flawlessly. They knew exactly what the hell the stepmother did flawlessly. It makes no goddamn sense that they are so perfect. They weren't even close to being that perfect the first Cinderella movie. I mean sure they helped her a lot, but they actually had to struggle to get Cinderella out of trouble. And even then, that didn't work. In this movie, they don't even have to fucking try to make sure that the stepmother does not get what she wants. Which she still does. It's still fucking stupid though, how she eventually lost. There was no reason for it to happen. There's absolutely no reason why Cinderella should have been able to get out of fucking anything that she went through. If this movie actually made sense, Cinderella would have been gone for good many times in the movie. But she got out since the movie lacks logic. Now it's time for my overall thoughts. Is this the worst direct-to-DVD Disney animated sequel? No, that would be The Hunchback of Notre Dame 2. But it is one of the worst, for sure. And for that, I want to give the rating 2 middle fingers. You have reached the end of the video. Thank you for watching and have a great day.